NMR instrumentation, it has got the 6 or 7 parts. First is sample holder, the permanent magnet, magnetic coils, sweep generator, radio frequency transmitter and radio frequency receiver, and the last is readout system. Means the instrument is composed of these 7 things. First of all, we would like to share the things regarding these things. That is, what is sample holder? Sample holder, it is a glass tube with 8.5 to long and 0.3 centimeter in diameter. If we talk about the permanent magnet, it provides homogeneous magnetic field which is 60 to 100 megahertz. Magnetic coils, the coils introduce magnetic field when current flows through them. What is sweep generator? It is to produce the equal amount of magnetic field which is passed through the sample, the sweep generator is used. The radio frequency transmitter, it is a radio transmitter coil that produces a short powerful pulse of radio waves. If we talk about the radio frequency, a radio receiver coil that detects receiver radio frequencies emitted as nuclei relax to the a number of energy levels. Last but not least, that is readout system, a computer that analyzes and records the data, which is a readout system. In NMR, we use some solvents to detect the NMR studies. First of all, would like to define and would like to discuss the solvents of NMR. The following solvents are normally used, which are hydrogen replaced by deuterium, that is CCl4 carbon tetrachloride, CS2 carbon disulfide, CdCl3 deuterochloroform, C6D6 hexa deuterobenzene, D2O deuterium oxide. And the next term, which is chemical shift, would like to share about the chemical shift. What is chemical shift? A chemical shift is defined as the difference in parts per million, that is ppm. If we talk about the parts per million, that is ppm, between the resonance frequency of the observed proton and tetramethyl alane TMS hydrogens. TMS is the most common reference compound in NMR. It is a set of 0 ppm. The chemical shift is nothing but it is a frequency of signal minus the frequency of reference upon the spectrometer frequency into 10 raised to power 6. Shielding of protons. If we talk about the shielding of protons, the high electron density around the nucleus shields the nucleuses from the external magnetic field, and the signals are upfield in the NMR spectrum. Deshielding of protons, lower electronic densities around a nucleus deshields the nucleus from the external magnetic field and the signals of the downfield in the NMR spectrum. There are some factors which affects the chemical shift. These may be electronegative compound. If the compounds are electronegative, it will affect the chemical shift. Magnetic isotropy of systems also affects the chemical shift. Hydrogen bonding is also very important part that shifts the chemical shift. Electronegative groups, Electronegative groups attached to the carbon hydrogen system decreases the electron density around the protons. And there is less shielding, that is deshielding, and chemical shift increases. As if we take the example of CH3I, it has chemical shift like 2.16. If we talk about CH3Br, the chemical shift is 2.65. And if we talk about CH3Cl, then it is 3.10. And if we talk about the CH3F, then it is 4.26. Means it is in the increasing order. If we talk about, means the CH3 is common, whereas iodine, bromine, chlorine, and fluorine, as the size increases, the chemical shift also increases. There are some examples which we can shift. The chemical shift can be defined. The values are given in this chart. Thank you. Today we'll study about the chemical shift only. In next lesson, we'll try to understand the other things which are important to understand the NMR.